The assignment, this whole exploration, you have taken it for yourself. And now we are looking at the fourth session of the induction program, where we are helping our students to look at their own aspirations, their own concerns at the individual level. So let's think about it. Now you are someone who is joining as a first year student, right? So we'll use the chat box. If you would like to put some of your own concerns when you were joining the college, some of your own aspirations, right? Anything, your aspirations, if you would like to put some of your aspirations, to get a job, Jayalakshmi ji is mentioning, yes, that is the aspiration. Okay, to earn more and more, Sudha ji is mentioning, okay, as a student, very nice. So we can ask our students to make a list. Higher education, Shashi Kumar ji is mentioning, very nice. Okay, to become a good engineer, I aspire to be a doctor, okay. Right. So the students are coming with lots and lots of aspirations, right? Now, with all that discussion we had yesterday, now we already discussed this assignment with our students, where we looked at our four levels of living. And now we are looking at the aspiration at the individual level. Yes, Kannanji is saying to become a social entrepreneur, to study well, get into university, to become a good teacher. Okay. So these are some of the aspirations which we can see. So the student wants to be happy, to be healthy, to be prosperous, quest of knowledge, right? Taking independent decisions, clarity in thoughts, self-confidence, and so on, right? You also gave a whole lot of list. So when we ask this first year student, the student comes up with a lot of aspirations, and we can just make a list of all these aspirations from the students. So now let's look at some of the concerns, right? You can think of so many concerns at your own level when you were getting into the college for the first time. You were also having lots and lots of concerns. The student is also coming up, yes. So how to talk with the opposite gender, very nice. These are some of the, how to mingle with the friends, yes. Very nice. These are some of the concerns. Missing parents, very true, very true. So we all can see that the students are able to have lots and lots of concerns. And we have listed few of them. They have this whole stress. They've gone through one of the toughest exams in their class 12, right? So, and then they are somehow under pressure of academics, very poor in time management, right? They want to ensure some kind of an entertainment for themselves. They don't have any clarity with that. Peer pressure, temptations. Yes, okay. Adildaid ma'am is servicing whether teachers will be good enough. Homesick, Sudha ma'am is mentioning. Right. So we all can see that the students are able to list their aspirations and concerns. Right. Now let's see. When we look at our aspirations as a student, we want to fulfill our aspirations. What do you think? How are we able to fulfill these aspirations? We can take some response. Okay. Dr. Pragyan Parimita Patnaikji, would you like to put forth something regarding this? We want to fulfill our aspirations. How can we fulfill? What should be the way out as a student? Whatever comes to you. Okay. Suresh sir, would you like to mention?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good
morning. Actually, I have the same doubt for the assignment also. The same question has been asked in the yesterday's assignment. What are the aspirations and concerns? What are the things needed for the fulfillment? The same question I have. They are given in terms of three things. How will you address it in terms of right understanding? And the second question is in terms of relationship, in terms of physical facilities. But I can't able to get, but I have given the answers. We do the self-exploration, we should have the better relationship, So like that, I have given the answers from yesterday's assignment, but still I want to get more clarity now. So we listed out the aspiration and concern, okay, but how to fulfill this in terms of different criteria, right? Understanding, relationship, physical facilities. And moreover, ma'am, one more doubt, we are saying right understanding, other 2 points are clear, relationship and the physical facilities, okay, but how to give clarity in the right understanding to these students? We are saying right understanding, but how to quantify that? Relationship mean you should have the better relationship with your friend or parents, like that you can say. And physical facility means you need to utilize minimum amount of facilities, you should not accommodate more. But how to quantify that right understanding?
Okay, sir. So let's take this question now. So we all will agree, right? If I am a student or as an individual, I want to fulfill these aspirations. The student too wants to fulfill these aspirations, right? Now let's see how we can ensure fulfillment of our basic aspirations. So our basic aspirations are fulfilled by this right understanding in the self, living with fulfillment in relationship and ensuring more than the required physical facility. So just like sir mentioned that as far as this point three is concerned, ensuring more than the required physical facility. So I am joining some professional college and I'm acquiring a skill. So with that skill, I can see that if I'm able to get that skill, I will be able to ensure the required physical facility if I have done the assessment of my needs, right? Fulfillment of relationship. Now, till date, whatever understanding I have, in my relationships, am I ensuring fulfillment? Let us put forth this question to our students, right? Now, when we say this right understanding is understanding harmony at all the four levels of our being. And that's what we are discussing as we proceed with these sessions with our students, where we are looking at harmony at each and every level. So this right understanding, ensuring this right understanding is that we are able to understand harmony at each and every level of our being. So right now, we are looking at the individual level and we are looking at how to ensure harmony at the level of the human being, that is at the individual level. So with all these proposals, right, one is able to see that I'm working on my right understanding. And with that, I'm in process of fulfillment of my basic aspiration. Is it fine, Suresh, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we are looking at that whole program and we are facilitating the student also. So the big question is that should my education help me in ensuring this right understanding or not? What do you think? So let us take this response from you that should my education ensure this right understanding and the right skills or not? This is the question which I can ask the students. As a student right now, you are answering this question. And meanwhile, we can take some responses while you're putting. This is the question we put forth to the students. Surek, answer.
Hello, madam.
Yes, sir. Ji.
Yeah, with respect to the present context, I have to speak, madam?
Yes, sir. As a student, if it comes to you.
Yeah, so definitely with respect to fulfillment of the aspirations. So anyway, at the large scale, I think we have to say that right understanding, living with fulfillment, ensuring something like this. But as a student point of view, I think generally we will be concentrating on only thing to get something. That is, for example, student will feel definitely I have to get some distinction result. So mostly I hope at the student level, so they are thinking at the present context rather than thinking about the basic aspirations. That is what I mean, madam.
See, but we are on the fourth session of the induction program. So yeah. On day one and day two, we had this discussion with our students where we have talked about whatever they want to be, right? And all that discussion is done now. So the student has that background where we have looked at the basic aspiration, right? So he can look at and explore within himself that the path can be many, but ultimately, as a human being, each one of us wants to ensure happiness and prosperity in continuity. And the way in which we can ensure that is through this right understanding. But the student is not clear what is this right understanding at this moment, because he has not discussed the proposals yet. So now the question is that should my education need to help me to ensure this right understanding or not? What do you think as a student? Should my education ensure the right skills in me or not? So yes, that I can ensure the physical facility.
Yes, madam. Education should ensure right understanding and it should ensure right skills, madam.
Very nice, sir. Very nice. So with all this discussion, we are trying to facilitate our students so that they themselves are able to explore for themselves. Babita ji, would you like to interact?
Yes, ma'am. So good morning, everyone. Ma'am, shayad main bhi agree karti hun jo sir ne kaha usse, that the right understanding is a process, ma'am. So jab बच्चे आएंगे, यस वी आर इन द फोर्थ सेशन, बट द होल ओरिएंटेशन सो फार विच दे हैव ब्रॉडली रिसीव्ड इज दैट एजुकेशन इज फॉर इम्पार्टिंग स्किल. कहीं पर बैकग्राउंड में उन्हें, मतलब बच्चे एक्सेप्ट करते हैं कि राइट अंडरस्टैंडिंग, बीइंग गुड ह्यूमन, विच दे ऑल्सो गेट फ्रॉम देयर फैमिली इन टर्म्स ऑफ वैल्यूज फ्रॉम द सोसाइटी, लेकिन वो बाय डिफॉल्ट हो जाना कि education for the right understanding, I think they would be still contemplating on that, and major focus will be on skill acquisition, ma'am.
So what you are mentioning is true in the sense that the student may come up with their own assumptions.
Ji, ma'am.
Just like, but see, as an individual, I may have a number of assumptions, but if I start exploring within me, I'm initiating that dialogue within me. And through that dialogue, just like I am exploring, I can see that the other is similar to me. So the other is also in this whole process of exploration, right? Where I'm putting the right input and leaving it for the other to explore. So I don't want any instant answers.
Proposal hum dete hain, तो जैसे हमारा एक रिफ्लेक्स सेक्शन होता है, सो यस, आई मीन थ्रू आर ओरिएंटेशंस, सिंस वी आर इन द फोर्थ सेशन ऑफ आर एसआईपी एंड यू नो थ्रू सेल्फ एक्सप्लोरेशन वी आर ग्रेजुएटिंग देम टू दैट राइट अंडरस्टैंडिंग. बट समवेयर आई थिंक मैम, जैसे हम लोगों ने हमारे एफडीपी के बाद बच्चों के साथ इंटरेक्ट किया, सो द रिफ्लेक्स और बाय डिफॉल्ट रिमेन्स स्किल्स. And when we, you know, further discuss with them, उन्हें और वो self exploration के opportunities देते हैं, और तब कहीं पे बच्चे वहाँ पर आने शुरू होते हैं कि हाँ, you know, right understanding matters या counts या उस तरह का.
Very, very true. It is a process, right?
जी,
so I'm not expecting that my student should understand everything at this very moment, but I'm leaving these questions which are open. Just like these questions are open to each one of us, these questions are open for the student, right? And we are not expecting the student to be transformed in a tenure of 3 weeks, but we are initiating that whole process. And in these 4 years, right, we will be giving continuous opportunity for the students where they can revisit the proposals. They can work on these proposals. And that's where our role as mentors is extremely significant.
Ji, ma'am.
We are interacting in the weekly meetings. We are looking at the proposals for ourselves, ensuring this process of investigation within ourselves. And in this whole process, I get this from within that I need to facilitate the other also. That is something which is naturally acceptable to me. So I hope our participants have put their responses in this poll, and we can just see that so many of us want the education to ensure this right understanding, and it should ensure the right skills. This is what we see. We, of course, are into this teaching profession. So maybe the students may not be able to give such clear-cut answers, but yet they will be able to reflect within themselves. Why are they pursuing all this education? What should be the purpose of this whole education, which they are spending so many years, right? So that is something which we can facilitate. Let us look at the concerns. The students have their own concerns, right? And we are discussing these concerns. So we can ask the students where they give their own list of their own concerns. And let's see, do we really want to resolve these concerns or not? So let me take that as a yes or a no from you all, right? So do we need, as a student, do I want these concerns to be resolved or not? So all of us are responding as students, very nice. And just like the students are going to say that, yes, I have some of these concerns. Not every student will have all the concerns, but yes, we can see the students facing these concerns. So if we want to resolve these concerns, right? Suppose there is this issue of time management with me, and I'm just looking at strategies to somehow manage my time, where I'm looking at some mind mapping skills, where I'm looking at some kind of timetable, some other issues, and so on. So generally, what kind of efforts as a student, as an individual, we are taking is a piecemeal kind of an effort, right? So for one kind of a concern, we are looking at some program. For other kind of concern, we are looking at some other kind of a program. So we are making effort to get rid of our concerns, but these efforts are in a way scattered. Right? So for time management, for anger management, for memory enhancement, for personality development, right? Within our own system, within our own organization, we are arranging so many programs for our own students, looking at their concerns, and yet they're lacking this coherence. Are you able to see this for yourself? What do you think? Right? If we just work for personality management, where we are looking at the behavioral aspect, right? So you should speak like this. You may be having disharmony, but the words should come out like this. So the kind of solutions we are looking at, the resolutions of these concerns, we are making effort for piecemeal solutions. Are you able to see some kind of an interdependence, an interlinking between these issues? Are these issues independent issues? Or these are interlinked issues? Are they these issues different, having separate kind of solutions, or can there be a basic root cause? What do you think about it as a student, right? This is coming as a question to you. We are asking our students. So let us take your reflection on this. So while you put your response to the reflection poll, let me hear from some of our participants over here. Ji, Dr. G. Kantimati ji. If we are able to reach you, Dr. G. Kantimati ji or Mrs. Shivani Dikshit ji.
Good morning, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes. Please go ahead, Kantimati ji.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. I'm very sorry to ask a very fundamental question. This I wanted to ask you when you were talking about this happiness and prosperity. Can you please explain the difference between happiness and prosperity? This is my first question. And the second question is, if we do have the right understanding, then I really don't understand why this prosperity comes into picture.
So when we say happiness, I'll briefly put forth, when we say happiness, it is the state of harmony, the state of synergy in which I want to continue forever. And this prosperity is where I'm able to get this feeling within me that whatever physical facility I need, I have more than that. And with that, I'm able to ensure this feeling of fulfillment within me, with this continuity of feeling of happiness and prosperity. That is my basic aspiration, right? And maybe in the afternoon, we can have more detailed discussion on this in the tutorial. Will that be fine, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, no issues. Thank you so much.
So let us look at these concerns. And are we able to see that whether they are interlinked or they are independent? Shivangi Dikshiti, would you like to interact? Okay, Abdul Rahman sir, would you like to interact regarding this? Mr. Abdul Rahman ji, you have the mic with you. Ji Abdul sir, your mic is unmuted.
Hello ma'am, I am audible. I hope so. I have a doubt here. I am working in an organization where I am be getting happy and I am happy and prosperity. But the package what I am receiving is something. I feel it's not satisfying my needs, but I'm getting another offer where I think that I'm not be happy and prosperous, but the package is more satisfying me. So in this situation, what should be my decision? Which preference should I give first?
So Abdul sir, your decision will be always yours, right? I can put forth the proposal.
Because I can't understand what is the natural acceptance here. Natural acceptance is something I want to sacrifice the happiness for the money, or something I want to sacrifice the money for the happiness, which should be the first priority.
So we can look at each and every proposal carefully. And with that, every time I have all this capability to take the decision for myself. So looking at your own need for physical facility and the correct assessment, this prosperity is something which you are going to define for yourself. Nobody else can do that for you.
So now, because in one perspective, if I have a money, I can satisfy my needs, and also as well I can satisfy my family needs as well as my relatives, and I can help others also. In this scenario, I can get happy. So something, the physical facility, money is related to something, the happiness. That is the question I have.
So Abdul sir, let us look at our own needs. Who needs it? And as we proceed further, right, we will be having more discussion on this so that we can see and make a correct assessment of how much physical facility is needed and whether I have more than that or I have less than that. If I make the right assessment and able to see that maybe I have less than that, I will work on the right kind of skills so that I can ensure that I have more than the required physical facility. Right? But all that decision I am going to take for myself. This is something which I can see for myself.
Yeah.
Nice, sir.
Thank you.
All are exploring for ourselves, and this exploration will facilitate that our decision which we take, that is towards this right understanding. So the poll is about to end. I hope all our participants have already responded to the poll, and we can see so many of us are saying that these concerns are interlinked, they are not independent issues, and there is a root, basic root issue of these many issues. This is what all of us are agreeing to. Most of the times, those who are not agreeing to this, they can further explore within themselves and they can see. So the basic proposal over here is that the issue is lack of this right understanding. When we don't understand a reality, we are not able to live with fulfillment with that reality. So if I don't understand myself as a human being, I'm not able to ensure this fulfillment within me. So now let us look at this whole reality, the human being, which I am, so that I'm able to live with this fulfillment within. I'm able to resolve all these individual level concerns which keep bothering me, this issue which is going on within me, anger, depression, right? All these are issues which are there within me. So I need to look at these concerns and see whether with these proposals, am I able to resolve my concerns or not? So let's try to understand ourselves as a human being. So when we look at ourselves as a human being, the proposal is that as a human being, self and body coexist. This is the existential reality, that a human being is a coexistence of the two existential realities, hell, self, and body. Right? Professor Vaicham Singh, sir, you have the mic with you. You wanted to ask something right now? Professor Vaicham Singh Sulia ji, if you want to ask something pertinent to this, or maybe we'll just continue, just to help the student, right? Just to facilitate the student, we pose these questions to the student. Who makes decisions? Yes, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
Yes, concern are many. I want to ask, there is not one only ideal solution for any concern.
Sir, I couldn't get your voice. Can you please repeat?
Ma'am, concerns and solution, you are talking about concerns and solutions.
See.
So there is not any ideal solution for any concern, I think.
We'll keep it open, sir, for us to explore whether there can be a solution. Whether there can be a holistic solution which can resolve all these concerns, or these concerns will continue with me. That is something which we can keep open and keep exploring.
Right? Yeah.
Very nice, sir.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
So, of course, as an individual, I can see that I have a number of concerns. Now, in order to resolve these concerns, we are looking at the proposal to understand a human being, right? So as a proposal, right now I'm exploring at this proposal that a human being is a coexistence of self and body. Now to facilitate the student, so as to get the clarity about the two existential realities, the self and the body, we'll ask this question. So let me ask this question to you all. Who is making this decision to be a part of the workshop? What do you think? Who is taking that decision that you are going to be part of the workshop? You're going to listen to this content. Is it the body or the self? Gee, so many responses are coming. So just like that, in the class also, we are asking this simple question. Who is making this decision to enjoy food, to enjoy music? Who feels high? Who feels elated, right? Who feels high? Who feels low? So we are getting some responses. Some are saying self, some are mentioning mind. Okay. Self, yes, we are getting so many responses. So with our student, we are putting these questions and the students are coming with their own answers, right? And we are enabling them to see that as a human being, I'm not just this body. I'm more than this body, right? So let's take the reflection from you all. Just like the students are going to put their reflection. And while you are putting your reflection quickly, we'll be hearing from Mrs. Kwarekapam Renuka ji. You have the mic with you.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I just want to go back to the previous slide where I have to encourage a student regarding the right understanding and the feeling of having relationships. Finally, right understanding, this is within the self. So I can make the student feel like what is right within themselves, but coming to the next level, that is a feeling of having relationship with others, because they have lots of concerns even before coming to the college and even after the college also. Like it's a competitive world, and instead of having being complementary to each other, they will compete. So even if I tell them, like, they have to be complementary to each other, they have to love each other or care about one another, but inside them, they will always have that competitive mindset, and then they will, I think, automatically it will lead to running after one another. So, like, will it be difficult for them to let them have the feeling of relationship? Like, it will be very conditional sometimes, yes, depending upon the condition, they will have a feeling of relationship, but will it be possible to have that feeling of relationship unconditionally?
So one after the other, we'll be looking at harmony at each and every level. So when we talk about relationship, we'll be discussing about harmony in the family, and there we'll be touching upon this issue regarding various feelings, competition, collaboration in more detail, right? So right now, since our focus is on individual concerns, all this anger which is there within me, the state of depression which keeps coming, the fears, the phobias which I have, right? So right now, because they have a number of assumptions, and I'm not saying that with one discussion we are able to erase out all the assumptions. We are not doing that. We are just enabling the student to initiate this whole exploration, where the student is trying to make himself ready to look for answers within, right? And this whole induction program is an initiation of that. So as a mentor, my role is to somehow initiate that self-dialogue within the student, where the student starts looking at these questions, which are important, which are somehow missed throughout the education system from which the student is coming.
Right? So because, ma'am, if I consider myself as a student, then I feel like it's very abstract to teach all those, I mean, to learn all those things.
To begin with, it appears to be abstract. But once I start this exploration within me, then I'm able to see it with clarity. Right? If I get a proposal and I'm able to ensure harmony within, I am able to live by that proposal. Right? This is what I will do for myself. Very nice. So when we are discussing these issues with the students, right, nobody has done that to them where they can put forth their own views. But now they come to this new setting. And as a mentor, now I'm discussing this with the students. So it provides them opportunity to open up, right? So I hope you all have put your responses, and we can just see so many of us are responding that it is the self which is making the decision. Maybe the students may not be able to conclude this. So we need to facilitate them so that they can have some kind of an understanding for this. So we can just help them by asking these little questions. So when you are going to make a choice for some kind of a movie, right? Who is making that choice? Which movie to watch? Which kind of music you want to listen? Who is making that choice? With all these little examples, right? We can proceed further with the students to let them know that when I look at myself as a human being, as a human being, I require food to nurture the body. Right? I require clothes to protect the body. Do I require happiness or not? What do you think? Gee, we are getting the response. So looking at my needs as human being, I have one set of needs, which are needs of the body, which are in terms of physical facility, food, clothes, right? Various instruments. And these needs are temporary in nature. We require them time to time, right? And there are other set of needs like happiness, right? Trust, respect, a affection, right? Do you need affection or not? Yes or no? We all can see. Do you want affection all times or you want affection sometimes? Do you want food all the times or you want food intermittently, time to time? What about food? Ji. So can we see the difference between the two kinds of needs we have? Need for happiness, need for respect, and need for food. Are there some differences between these two kinds of needs? Can you see that? Are these needs of different types or same type? Can we ignore any type of need? Or do we want fulfillment for both the types of needs? What do you think? We can facilitate our students with this little example, right? Some example like you go to your friend's place, your friend is very close to you. The moment you meet him, you feel so happy, right? You are spending hours and hours with your friend. Now you're very happy in the company of your friend, but for hours, the friend didn't even ask for a glass of water. Can you continue like this? Where you are sitting for hours and yet the need for the physical facility of the body is not taken care of. Or the other way around, you go to your friend's place, he puts the table with everything which you like on the table, but then he says something which is insulting to you, which makes you unhappy. So at any given point of time, are we working to fulfill both the types of needs? Are we ensuring both the types of needs, the needs of the self as well as the needs of the body? Right? Let's take this reflection from you quickly. And let me ask, how as a teacher, as a mentor, suppose... So while you're putting your response, let me ask this question to you. So I am a student right now and you are my mentor. So with this whole thing that the need of the body are temporary. So let us put this. How is the need for the body temporary because I need air every time? So if the student is asking this question, how are we going to answer? Dr. Seema Patelji, would you like to respond to this? If the student comes up with this query to you, Dr. Ramnath, Mr. Ramnath Chaudhary ji, would you like to answer? If the student comes with this query, let's see, this air is needed and it is needed in continuity. How can you say that the need for the body is temporary? Would you like to respond to this? Any of our participants would like to respond to this? Veena ji, you have the mic with you.
Namaste, ma'am.
Please.
Need of the body is temporary because we are getting satisfied for that instance. Like for example, food. So once we get that, we are satisfied. We don't need it in continuity. Like time to time, we need it. And it is in terms of quantity. So if we get enough amount of quantity, we'll be immediately satisfied with that. And we'll not have again a question about it after that time of period. So
but the student is confused now. The student says that, look, I require air. The body needs air. Right? And
yes.
Continuity.
So yes. But ma'am. Coming to the air, or which is a basic requirement, which is naturally available to us. So those kind of things we are not producing or we are not manufacturing.
Right.
So that is continuously available to us. So we can't take that as a physical facility. So physical facility, mainly what we are looking here is in terms of what need to be manufactured or produced by means of the process, what we follow.
We'll just hold it for a moment, Veena ji, and maybe let me take one more response. Any of our participants who would like to answer this for their students? Sushma ji is there. Sushma Shishadil ji or...
Hello.
Ji.
Yes, ma'am. Hello.
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 Actually, air is not continuous. It is discontinuous because breathe in and breathe out.
जी
सो इट इज डिसकंटीन्यूअस प्रोसेस नॉट
कंटीन्यूअस जी सुषमा मैम यू वर आल्सो मेंशनिंग समथिंग
यस मैम मैम द थिंग इज व्हेन वी वर मेंशनिंग अबाउट द बेसिक नेसेसिटीज लाइक फूड क्लोथिंग शेल्टर वाटर दीस आर ऑल द मोस्ट बेसिक फॉर एवरी ह्यूमन बीइंग्स एग्जिस्टेंस एंड वी एज वी वर डिस्कसिंग यस्टरडे देयर हैज टू बी अ शिफ्ट from the animal consciousness, because these are all the things which we cannot be very happy and contented with. This is not just, we have a greater purpose than that of the animals, right? So even the animals want food, the basics, that's all easily available. What we need to convey to students is, since we have a higher level of understanding, a higher level of want, so probably we need to... Hello?
Please go ahead.
Probably we should make the students aware that yes, that is as if the student asks, here is important, yes, all that is important. But that you should rise above that and think of other things rather than just staying at the animal level, basic level. Yes, for me, food is enough, shelter is enough. Our purpose is even more greater than all the, than just fulfilling the basic needs, ma'am.
So let's look at this whole thing. Right, this whole discussion, let's see that the student now is first introduced to self and body. Now, when we say physical facility, this physical facility is all what is needed by the body, irrespective of whether it is basic or not so basic. I suppose that people have responded to this poll. So the poll is just about to end. And all of us, we see that the needs of self and body are different. Some are saying that no, they are not different. So we can keep it open for them who are in process of exploring whether the need for the self and the body are different or not. So they can continue with this exploration and with the discussion we are having. With all that discussion, they can initiate this dialogue within themselves. So when we say physical facility, anything we are getting from the nature, right? Needed by the body. That is a physical facility. Be it air, water, which is freely available, but yet it is a physical facility, right? And just as sir mentioned, that even if I require air, if I just closely observe it, the requirement for the air is also intermittent, which means that I am breathing in and then there is a gap. I need to breathe out first, right? The air that I breathe in is different and the air that I breathe out, right, which is rich in carbon dioxide, is different. And then only I am ready again to breathe in. I cannot continue that throughout. So with the student, we should be able to, with clarity within us, when we say physical facility, it is not just something extra. It is every little thing I need for the body. That is the physical facility. And we are not differentiating between anything like basic or not so basic. So this physical facility is needed for the body, whatever I'm getting from this whole nature, in order to nurture the body, in order to rightly protect the body, in order to rightly utilize the body. All that is physical facility. And one of the example of the physical facility we take as food, which is a basic example, so that we all can relate to it. That this food, if somebody starts feeding me continuously, can I make this requirement of food in continuity? Yes or no? So all of us do agree that I cannot have this food in unlimited quantity, right? And this goes with any physical quantity which is needed for the body. Any physical quantity needed for the body is always in a limited amount. And in order to fulfill the need for the body, the need for the body is always fulfilled by some physiochemical thing which is available around me in this nature. But the need for the self, this happiness which I want in continuity, let's ask this question to ourselves and to our students. Throughout the day, just check, is there any moment when you don't want to be happy? You may be unhappy, that is the state. But let us look at our want. Is there any moment throughout the day when I don't want to be happy? When I don't want to be respected? Is it that I want respect, enough of respect, now there should be some disrespect with me? What do you think? Right? Once I have enough of food, I say enough of food, let me give a break. Do I that with respect? Enough of respect, I don't want any more of respect, let me get some disrespect. Enough of affection, let me get some jealousy for myself. Do I do that? Do I want that for me? So we are getting answers, never, right? So this need for happiness, which is in continuity, which is qualitative in nature, in terms of feelings, is fulfilled by right understanding and right feeling. That is something which we can see, right? Now let's see, can physiochemical things fulfill the needs of the self? What do you think? Who needs the physiochemical things? Self or body? Gee, so many are saying that the body needs the physiochemical things. And what happens when I plan to buy a luxury car for myself? Looking at the car of my friend, am I ensuring that the need of the body is fulfilled? Or somehow I'm associating the need of the self. So the need of the body cannot be fulfilled by right understanding and right feeling alone. Right? I may have this right understanding, I may have this right feeling within me. I have this feeling of relationship for the other. I have this right understanding. But I need food to nurture the body. Right? Similarly, the needs of the self cannot be fulfilled by physiochemical things. Just like I cannot do the other way around. So both the types of needs have to be understood separately. Who needs happiness? I need to be clear of this. Both the types of needs are to be filled separately. And this is very important. With our students, we can just ask, till now, how much time and effort is spent for right understanding and right feeling? How much time and effort we are spending, the student is spending for physical facility. He has made a program for himself. He has joined a four-year program. He'll be putting effort in that four-year program. Till now also he has passed class 12, right? He has put a lot of effort. So what is the priority? Are we able to see the time and effort we are spending for right understanding and right feeling? Let us take your reflection before. While you put your reflection to this, let us hear from Prasanna Kumar sir. So Prasanna Kumar sir, suppose the student comes up with this query that, look, you say that physiochemical things are needed for the body. So the clothes are needed for the body. But what about fashion? What will my friend say?
Actually, madam, good morning.
Hey, good morning, sir.
See, both are actually needed, is it no, madam? So body and self should coordinate each other because they are coexistence. So if the student asks, okay, so needs the body cannot fulfilled by right understanding. This is, I think, a wrong message. With right understanding, body can be fulfilled with right understanding, no, madam?
just with right understanding and right feeling alone, I cannot fulfill the needs of the body. I need to ensure the physical facility too, with that right understanding.
Yes, of course, madam. Physical facility is needed, but to what extent we need that physical facility, that is very
important. That will come with right understanding.
Yes, yes, madam. That is important. Very. And I raised my question to ask some of the doubts in the previous slides regarding concerns, madam. See, these concerns, maybe the student concern, maybe getting the good placement, and if he is not getting, he may be depressed, or some concerns will be there, madam. Is it? So, how this UHBC, we are discussing only about, you know, concerns, aspirations, and the relationship, understanding, physical facility, all these things we are discussing. How this UHB will address those personality related things? If so, at what extent it will address?
So, since all our participants have gone through the introductory workshop once, so the content is, at least we all have gone through the content once. So just giving you an example. For example, there is this issue of anger, right? This Now, if I'm able to see that this anger that comes within is due to this lack of trust on intention.
Yeah.
Once I get this clarity, right? I'm able to resolve the issue. So the concerns which the student might be seeing right now, slowly with the proposals, one is able to relate that if I'm able to take that proposal and explore for myself, one after the other, with more and more clarity about myself as a human being, about relationship and family, about the goals I have in this society and my role in this nature and existence, I'm able to live with fulfillment. I'm able to resolve my concerns.
Yes, madam. Yes, sir.
Is it fine, sir?
Madam, see one thing. See, the student get a good placement that relate to happiness. He will get a very, he will become very happy once he get the good placement. So from the placement, he will get physical facility. So that both are self, you know, coexistence. Okay. So to get that happiness, that means to get his good job or good, you know, company with a good package, all these things. So happiness, how the happiness will be related to this, getting good job?
So suppose now my student gets a good placement.
Yeah.
Right? And now in the current scenario, he is temporarily happy.
Okay.
He joins the organization, but unable to work in a team.
Okay.
Because he lacks relationship. He lacks feelings in relationship. So how long will he be able to continue with his feeling of that temporary happiness after getting a good placement? Can that be continued?
Once he get the good placement, I hope that happiness will continue, no?
The moment he joins the organization, right, he has to work with human beings.
Oh.
Right? Where he is lacking this feeling of relationship throughout.
Okay.
Right? How long will he be continuing with this feeling of happiness, so-called temporary happiness, that he got the best package?
Oh, okay. Okay, madam. Yeah.
Now, we are looking at lifelong learning.
Yeah, lifelong learning. Yes.
And and we are putting these proposals for our students so that they can initiate this exploration within. That this, I need to understand harmony at the level of individual, at the level of family, at the level of society, at the level of nature and existence. And that will ensure happiness in continuum. Yeah.
Yes, madam, that definitely the harmony, if you maintain within individual, society, in the, you know, family, definitely we will get happiness. So and that itself will leads the students to get the better life. That means a better placement and come out of all his, you know, depression or whatever this.
So the question is where to start from. Where to start from? Right?
Yes. Yes, yes, madam.
Where to start from? That is an important question.
Yes, yes, madam.
So where to start from? Whether at the level of individual, at the level of family, at the level of society.
For a student, it should be from individual level, no, madam.
G. See, so we are facilitating the student so that the student can look at himself more carefully.
Yes.
Very nice.
Okay. 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 Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
All these explorations are important for us so that we are able to see what the student is going through. So the responses that we get, both the needs are to be fulfilled. So many are saying yes, some are saying no regarding the priority and regarding the time and effort. The time, 48% are saying that we are spending most of the time and effort for physical facility. 48% are saying no and 3% are saying cannot say. So we ourselves are exploring and we are keeping this exploration open for our students also. Now that we have put forth these important questions to our students, they are going to begin their own exploration where they look at their own priority. Further, as far as the activity are concerned, we can see that with body, each and every activity is temporary. Eating, walking, speaking. But with self, this whole activity of desire, thought and expectation that runs in me continuously. Are you able to make that observation for yourself? This desire, thought, expectation continuously going on in you every moment? Yes or no? What do you think? So let us suppose that with this discussion, the student comes up with this, that look, how can I say that this desire, this thought, this expectation is continuously going on in me? How can I say that this activity of desire, thought and expectation is running in me in continuity? I may be sleeping at times. I can't say that it is in continuation. So if the student comes with this kind of a question. Okay, Ranganathan sir wants to respond to this. G. Ranganathan sir, you have the mic with you. Would you like to respond to this question when the student comes up with this query?
Yes, madam. One of my students asked me when desserts are unending, there is no end at all. We go on, we get one thing, again we aspire one thing. So struggling for getting the desired goals or desired target is a continuous process. So physical facility also should be enhanced proportionately to achieve the things. He asked me, happiness never ends. Once we get one thing, again we feel for getting some other thing, madam. So I could not answer him properly.
So as long as we are trying for this happiness to be ensured by physical facility.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Are we able to achieve that?
Yes.
That is something we have to explore for ourselves, right? This happiness is something which I need.
Yes.
And the physical facility is something which the body needs.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
So we have to...
Yes, yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
So now the student is coming up with this query that
yes.
How can you say that this activity of desire, thought and expectation is running in me continuously? Because yes. I may sleep at times.
Yes. Yes.
Nityaji, would you like to respond to this? Nitya Natarajanji, would you like to respond to this? Okay, Nachiketa ji, if we are able to reach you.
Yes, madam. Madam, actually, madam ji.
Ji ji, please sir, please go ahead sir.
Actually, I have got a little amount of digression, may not be related to this thing, but just as a curiosity, I am asking. In our philosophy, there is also Advaita, non-dualism. That means the body and the self that you are talking of are not two separate things. And in some dualism, they are telling that body and the self are two separate things. This is number one. And number two, as far as this...
Sir, I'll just like to ask you one simple thing. Right now, when you are communicating to me, are you just body?
No, madam. No, that is that consciousness. I am thinking actually into that we are separate, the body and the self. That is right. Just
like you can make that observation. Can the student also make that observation for himself?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Definitely. And there is a second question, ma'am. This desire, thought, and expectations, as far as their continuity is concerned. Sometimes we have seen that if you are very, very happy or if you are in a meditative consciousness, at least for a fraction of a second or for some time, this desire, thought, and expectations, they cease to exist. So can we say that this is also continuous?
So let us take it like this. So you are in a meditative state,
right?
In that meditative state, is this thought there that you want to continue in that state?
I don't think, madam, probably that is a thoughtless state when the thoughts
let's keep it to open. Exist. Let's keep it open and see for ourselves that when I am in this state of meditation, right, whatever, where I am experiencing this harmony within me, right?
Yes,
I want to continue with that state.
Yes.
I want to continue, which means that I have this thought of continuing in that state for more and more time.
Yes, maybe you are right.
And then when I'm sitting in that state, right? And then suppose I've decided that for 15 minutes or 20 minutes, I want to continue in that state, right? And after 15, 20 minutes, I have to get back to my work. Now let's see how many thoughts are crossing. Let's make that observation for ourselves.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? All this is going on in me, is it?
Yes.
So this is something which I can do for myself, where I can see whether this activity is going on in me in continuity or not. So if the student comes up with this query, the student may have this doubt. They may come up with this query that, look, I am sleeping also. How do I get to know that this activity of desire, thought, expectation is running in me in continuity? So how are you going to facilitate the student so that the student is also able to explore that this activity is going on in continuity? Gurleen ji, would you like to?
Yes, ma'am. I think I'll be talking about that even while the student is sleeping, you know, in the subconscious also, there's some thoughts, you know, during the day, what they've been doing. So they are also running, and that is why we dream. So I think with this example, I think they'll understand that even at times, or we can just give them, a 1 minute break and tell them, okay, don't think about anything. But if something is coming to your mind, just jot it down. And with this small activity also, they realize that even when they try not to have a thought, there is some thought playing in their mind. So I think I'll give that example.
Nice. So we all can see that when we are sleeping, we all dream. Now, what are dreams? Once we ask this, the student is able to relate that this activity, this thought, this desire, this expectation, they are running in continuity and they're able to see the difference, right? So once we are able to put forth all these proposals, right? The self, the body being the two existential realities. Now with all that discussion, let us put forth these simple questions to the students. So while selecting and eating food, what is desirable? Now you are answering like a student. So what is it that is desirable? Body is nourished, self is happy. Body is nourished, but self is unhappy. Body is not nourished, self is happy. Body is not nourished and self is also unhappy. So as a student, the kind of response we are going to get, right? We will take quick that response in this. You have to respond like a student because we are asking this question. It is relevant to them, right? One of the issues which the parents are facing is this whole habit of junk food, right? Now the student or the child is making his own choice with all this clarity. So while you are putting your response, maybe let us hear from Dr. Monalisa Mohanty ji. और मिसेस वी सुमति जी
जी जी नमस्ते जी एक्चुअली एज फार एज कंसर्न स्टूडेंट्स व्हेन द बॉडी इज नरिश द सेल्फ विल बिकम हैप्पी because they don't know about the other things. They need their physical facility. So at that time, they need only the tasty food. For example, if we take fried item or tasty food, so if their body get nourishment, their self gets happy at that time. Say they don't know about the cause and effects of the food or maybe the oily food like that.
Sumati ma'am, we are asking this after the discussion.
Yes, right? Yes, Didi. Yes, Didi.
We have discussed about the body. We have discussed about the self.
Yes, Didi.
Now we are asking this question. So we can't say that the student is not knowing about the self and the body. With that clarity now, when we ask this question to the student,
yes, right? Didi.
The student
yes.
is also exploring along with us, just like we are exploring for ourselves.
Yes, Didi. Yes, Didi.
We cannot go by this assumption that a student doesn't know anything.
Oh, okay, Didi.
Right?
Yes, Didi.
Is going through all this discussion. This is what we are discussing in the induction program. These are the slides we choose in the induction program.
Yes, Didi.
So now let's see what kind of response the students are going to give.
Yes, Didi.
Is it fine, Didi?
Yes, Didi. Yes, Didi.
Nice, very nice. So we all are exploring for ourselves and seeing this for ourselves and facilitating our students also simultaneously. So I hope all of you have put your response to this particular poll, just like a student is going to do. And we can just see that with all this discussion, now the student is in a position to see that the choice of the food is should be such that the body should be nourished and the self should also be happy about the choice. And that is something which is important, right? Where the student is taking his own decision, right? So we can just facilitate further with the discussion. Like, let's find out what happens at the level of self and body when someone is forcing you to eat when you are not hungry. In all that process, even though the food is reaching the body, who is getting violated? Right? When you make some selection, when you're eating some junk food, are you taking care of that the body is nourished and the self is also equally happy? What kind of food choices are you going to make with all this clarity? Now, if while serving, someone pushes the plate to you, even though the food is tasty, it is nutritious, will you take that food? No. Everyone is saying no. So can I continue if my self is unhappy? Can I let myself be violated? So let's see, when I am getting this clarity within me about the two existential realities, the self and the body, coexisting to make me as a human being. So when is it that we tend to make more mistakes? When the self is disturbed within or when the self is comforted? What do you think? While you're putting your response to this reflection poll which is coming to you, we would like to hear from Swati ji. Swati Polsa ji, you have the mic with you. While you're putting your response to this question, just like students are responding with all this discussion. Swati ji?
Yes, ma'am. Am I audible?
Ji, please.
When self is more disturbed within, we tend to make more mistakes, madam.
So I did want to make that observation for yourself.
Yes, I did.
Very nice, ma'am. Balbir sir also wants to say something.
Yeah, while writing examinations, people could not recollect, I mean, students could not recollect, even though their body is in comfortable state, their self, lackage of harmony in self, they could not recollect even though the things they have read.
Very properly. Very nice observation.
Thank you.
Balbir sir?
Good morning, madam. So my opinion is also that when that self is disturbed within, then one is not able to take control of even self, that the thoughts also, and taking the some wrong decisions and taking or making the mistakes, whether it is, and again to make happy or to make comfortable, then he may take a wrong decisions. Sometimes that drug abuse or like that, some other things are also coming, that is wrong notions are also coming when one is not comfortable or in harmony, that is in the other refined word. So that is all, I agree with that. So the question is that, how the one can be a in the harmony state always, that is the only the question.
Nice.
Again, when students are there, whether the students are able to think at this level or not, because a student always see the immediate results. So because they are so much, they are conditioned from their parents or society that I have to take admission, I have to become an engineer, I like that. They go only up to that stage, but they are not going beyond that. So beyond that, that is a, what is the ultimate or what is the basic aspirations are there. So they are not thinking about that. They think that,
sir, just to share the experience, we have been taking this course over the last 10 years in our university, and we have seen that the students are more quick to take up the proposal as compared to the elderly ones who are far more preconditioned.
Okay. This
is just to share the experience. So when these proposals are discussed with the students, they themselves come up with lots and lots of exploration with it.
Right. Right. Nice.
Very.
Thank you. Thank you.
Pertinent question. So we see that we are able to do more mistakes when we are disturbed inside. Most of us are able to make this. And the students are also able to see with all this discussion around. So we can ask this to students, that does a small child also needs respect? How do we interact with respect? Do we interact in all cases, or this respect is conditional or unconditional? So let us take one quick response from you once again regarding this. And while you are responding to this, let us hear from you. So do we interact with all with respect? Mr. Utkarshji, would you like to interact? Corresponding to this reflection poll, are we interacting with respect in all cases, or is it conditional? What do you think? We have Professor Sashmita Samantaji. Would you like to interact, ma'am? Professor Sashmita Samantaji? I hope our participants are able to get the voice.
You're nicely audible, Didi.
I'm not audible, Didi.
You're audible, perfectly audible.
Dr. Bikas Raoji, you have the mic with you. Would you like to interact?
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. Yeah, I think we should interact with equal respect with a sweeper, a rich man, whatever the option is given. Day to day life, we are not doing it. So that is the thing.
Very honest reflection, very sincere reflection, that this is what we are doing as a mistake. Right. In fact, the responses are there, and we can see some of us saying that in all cases, we are interacting with respect. Some are saying very honestly that it is conditional. And some say that we cannot say. Gee, nice. So let's see, are needs for all the human beings same? with all this discussion we had, right? Or the needs are different for different people. What do you think? We can put responses in the chat. Are the needs same for all human beings? Can we see that each one of us is a coexistence of self and body? Is the program for fulfillment of needs the same for all human beings, or it keeps varying from person to person? Can it change for men, for women, for young, for old, for students? Will it vary? What do you think? We are getting some response. So many are saying that the program remains the same for all. So we can see that with this little discussion in our classrooms, we are able to ensure that our students get this clarity. Right? So all what we have discussed right now, that a human being is a coexistence of the self and the body. And the body needs the physical facility, which is fulfilled by physiochemical things, which comes from the rest of the nature. Happiness is the need of the self, which is to be fulfilled by right understanding and right feeling in the self. It cannot be fulfilled by physical facility. It cannot be fulfilled by just getting feelings or expecting feelings from the other. So with this, this is some of the home assignment which we discuss with our students. This home assignment is what we do with the students in the session. So from your exploration of human being, could you see that you have two types of needs? A set of needs which are continuous and a set of needs which are temporary. So we ask the students to make a list of these needs and just list out which of them are in continuity and which are required time to time, so that the student can clearly differentiate between the kinds of needs. Then another task is, if you feel happy when someone pays attention to how you look, your clothes, your way of speaking, find out if you get continuous happiness from this process of getting attention from the others. And then another assignment which we give to the students is to do an experiment and find out if you can get continuous happiness from eating food. So whatever you like, you can take that and you can start eating in continuity. Does that taste continue for you? So the student can get an idea about that, a physical facility, can it really be a source of my happiness? Right? So these are some doable exercises. And with all this, what we have been able to discuss, the key points which we want to convey to our students, where we can see that the human being is a coexistence of the self and the body. There's a difference between the needs, activities, and the response of self and body. There is this whole entity, which is this conscious entity self, and the body is the material entity, right? And with the help of examples, when we are able to illustrate to our students, so that the students are able to make out that.